हेलो फ्रेंड्स, केजी क्लासेस में आपका स्वागत है। आज हम आपको एल्डोस हाग्जिले के शॉर्ट आंसर के बारे में बताएंगे। क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट, राइट ए नोट ऑन डिसीज स्नोवरी। इज इट द स्टूपिडिटी ऑफ यूथ। आंसर, इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द एसे हाग्जिले क्लेम्स दैट ऑल मैन आर स्नोब्स अबाउट समथिंग और देयर इज नथिंग ऑन विच वी डू नॉट फील स्नोबिश। He starts to classify these snowberries with the snowberry of disease. Usually nobody wants to be ill and snobbish for it, but the youths feel snobbish about the mild diseases. Nobody is found snobbish of leprosy. On the other hand, there are men and women who possess sufficient wealth and leisure and travel from spa to spa in search of cures for their disease, in some cases connected with the overeating. Such men take pride in having these maladies. There are some snobs who are proud of the disease like tubercle, because in some ways this disease by related with Keats and Mary. These youths like to disappear in the flower of youth. These snobs are foolish enough not to know about the final stages of consumption. Question second, write a note on booze snowberry as mentioned by Hagjale. Answer, snowberries have an empire which declines and rises. Today the snowberry of family is on the decline everywhere with the growth of the population. The snowberry of culture is nowadays to conflict with other snowberries. There are people who take pride of their culture. Then there is snowberry of drinking warn of American prohibition. These people think it is social respect to have strong drinks. These people, if not in public, may be seen drunk in the hot-tempered privacy. Even females too, from 15 to 70, may be found drunk. To this end, France pursues costly kind of wine. Question third, briefly discuss modernity snobs. Is modernity snob the best friend of industrialist? Answer, a modernity snob wants to remain up to date. He possesses to be fashionable and modern. This attitude is found among the person through the means of advertisement. People should use the latest productions. The industrialist teach the people to consume the latest article and produce new things very soon with a slight change. Houses, shoes, clothes and motor cars are the items of modernity snobbery. They must be in fashion for all days. In this way, the consumers throw away their old possessions and buy new articles at the higher rate. In this way, modernity snobbery is industrialist's best friend. Next question is, what do you know of art snobbery? Answer, art snobs are of two kinds. Some of them praise the symbols of culture and those others purchase them. Most of the art snobs buy the culture symbols of old masters because it is a safer investment and symbol of wealth. A long fleet of motor cars is not so big a symbol of prosperity as the art symbols. Collection of the old paintings, statues and symbol is the symbol of culture snobbery. Besides, those who buy works of art provide a living to artist. Therefore, art snobbery too is a symbol of wealth and prosperity. Some other who possesses no wealth take an interest in the art symbols. Question fifth, is snobbery an active virtue? How? Answer, snobbery has a social respect. If we are desires of remaining active, the snowberries are good enough because we are promoted to spend enough money for the purchase of new things. It encourages us to earn more and more. On the other hand, if we consider all activities in this world of illusion as outright bad, we shall condemn all snowberries out of hand. Snowberry stimulates activity. If we think like Buddhist, we shall condemn snowberry. Every snowberry demands unceasing efforts from its devotee. Every snowberry demands to be active. Disease snowberry requires to run from doctor to doctor. Modernity snowberry demands to earn more. Next question is, how does Huxley conclude his views about snowberry? Answer: Huxley advocates a middle position between the two extremes. We regard some activities as good and others as either indifferent or bad. We should approve of the snowberries that encourage good activities. A professional intellectual will approve of the culture snowberry because it leads rich people to pay for the works, products by intellectual, and thus encourages the free flow of ideas as well as of wealth. A modernity snob is expected to earn more money. Huxley warns the snob that a society with plenty of snowberries is like a dog with plenty of fleas having no rest. Therefore, we should be careful to grow excessively snob. Huxley suggests to make our position in the mid so that we may remain full of rest and with the contemporary time. Question 7. Briefly discuss the wide range of Huxley's essays. Answer: Aldous Huxley was a great writer. He wrote prose, poetry, biography, drama, short stories, and essays. Nearly he handled each form of literature except one act play. It is wonderful about him that he covers a wide range of his subject matter and manner. Apart from his purely creative art, he wrote on painting, science, moral, music, philosophy, and religion. His range of interest was wide and his concern for humanity deep. His essays are concerned with the wide range of love, sex, logic, politics, philosophy, and different entertaining subjects. He was well equipped with humor and art. His irony is as remarkable as his satires. He made fun of the sophisticated subject and customs prevalent in the society. He was a moralist, and there is a note of morality in his prose. His essays show his Getty. Question 8. Write a note on didactic note of selected snowberries. Answer: Huxley found the mankind sick. It was broken by the two world war and other civil wars. He found the world under universal tension. He advocated that man's problems are not economic or ethical, but they are concerned with the psychology. The main problem facing the modern age is how to bring about a change in mind and heart. His mental and emotional outlook to develop humanitarian and philanthropic tendency. His essays show universal message. In selected snowberries, he narrates a universal appeal. It is not limited to any nation or age. He points out that all men are snob about something. Some of them are proud of one thing, others for another thing. If some of them have nothing, they seem proud of some disease they possess. Person person who are not ill try to show themselves ill and wander from doctor to doctor in search of cures. The problems do not belong to us in the way as we watched. This is the problem of thinking that we are in sympathy. Writer's message is universal in a great style. Thanks, best of luck.